In this video, we will model a physical problem that you often encounter in calculus textbooks, a mixing problem. But why is this problem treated in so many textbooks? Well, for several reasons. First of all, it's in general very hard to model real-life problems. A mixing problem is relatively easy, both in terms of modeling and in terms of mathematics, so it's a good problem to start with. And secondly, it can already be applied to real-life problems, like the concentration of pollutants in a lake as a function of time. So let's take a look at the mixing problems, and in this video we'll focus on the modeling part. So if you model, we'll always start with some picture, with some sketch. Here we have a sketch of a water tank, and there is some water with, say, some solute inside, so water plus, say, salt. And the concentration of the salt in the tank is given by C as a function of T. Now, we model the tank as well stirred, so the C of T, this concentration of salt, is everywhere the same in the entire tank. What do we do then? Well, we add some solution with, at a rate R in meter cubed per second, with some concentration of salt C in kilograms per cubic meter. And at the same time, we do not only increase the volume in the tank, but we also have an outlet with some rate out, of course, in meter cubed per second as well. And in the outlet, we also have a concentration C out. And since the tank is well stirred, this C out concentration equals C of T, the concentration of the salt in the tank. So we get some liquid in with some concentration, so we get mass of salt in, and something goes out as well. And then the question is, what happens to the total mass of salt in the tank, or what happens to the concentration of the salt in the tank? So how can we try to solve that problem? Well, at T equals zero, when we start, we have some initial volume in cubic meters given, and some initial mass in kilograms given. And the question is, what happens if time goes on? Does all salt disappear through the outlet, or does the amount of salt increase? Well, let's try to model this. We'll need two balance equations. First, the balance of the volume. So what happens to the volume? The delta V equals delta V in, what enters the tank, minus delta V out, what leaves the tank. So how can we compute this delta V? Well, this delta V is approximately equal to the rate in meter cubed per second times delta T in seconds. So if you take this product, you get a meter cubed minus what leaves the tank, R out times delta T, also a meter cubed. Approximately equal, because those rates in and rates out could change if you close the outlet, for example. And the rate out could depend on time. So that's why the approximately equal sign is here. Then we divide by delta T, and we have delta V over delta T is approximately equal to rate in minus rate out. And it only is equal, well, if the rate in and rate out are constant, but they are more or less constant. If you take your delta T very, very small, and they become constant in limit delta T to zero, and in that case, dV dt equals R in minus R out. So that will give us the balance for our volume. Then, next, the balance of the mass. What about the mass of the salt in the tank? Well, something similar. The delta M equals delta M which comes in minus delta M which goes out. And what do we know about delta M in and delta M out? So delta M is approximately equal to what comes in. Well, what comes in over here at a rate in meter cubed per second times the concentration in kilogram per meter cubed times the delta T. So what you get here is meter cubed per second times kilogram per meter cubed equals kilogram per second times those seconds gives you a kilogram. That's what goes in the tank. So what's the delta M out? Is what's leaving over here. This is a similar expression, but now we get the R out, C out, and again our delta T. Approximately equal, Because the sea in or the sea out, etc., they all could change in this small time interval delta t. So as long as we have a non-zero, a finite delta t, we have delta m over delta t, we divide by delta t, is approximately equal to r in c in minus r out c out. And again, we do the same trick. We take the limit delta t to zero, so we get dm dt. If you take your delta t very small, then the c is approximately constant. And same holds for all the reads. So dm dt equals r in c in minus r out c out. And how can we then finally relate this c out to the mass? Well, c out was equal to the concentration of the salt in the tank, because the salt is well stirred. And for the concentration, we know that c out equals c of t, and concentration is equals mass over volume, mass in the tank divided by the volume in the tank of the salt. So let's summarize. We have a balance equation for the volume over here. Dv dt equals rate in minus rate out, and some initial volume. So that is one differential equation for the volume. And secondly, we have a mass balance equation, which gives us an equation for the dm dt, a differential equation. Dm dt equals r in c in minus r out c out, and c out equals m over v, and some initial mass. So in order to model our mixing problem, we have to solve two differential equations, one for the volume and one for the mass balance. We'll do that in some explicit examples in some future videos.